One of the most common questions we get is, how do I fit the bit to my horse's mouth properly? One common misconception is that people want to fit the bit so that there's one wrinkle or two wrinkles or three wrinkles at the corner of the horse's mouth. And they're always saying, well, I know it's right because I have one wrinkle or two wrinkles or three wrinkles. That is not the way to decide if a bit is fitting or how to fit the bit properly. The first thing you want to do is put the bit in the horse's mouth and then just take your fingers, touch the edge of the tongue, and the horse will roll its tongue back as far as it can. You want to make sure that the horse can't get its tongue up behind the bit. If it can't and it's meeting the corner of the horse's mouth, that may be sufficient. However, some horses really prefer a little more contact at the corners. In that case, you can move it back up just a bit so you've got a little wrinkle there. Your horse's behavior is going to tell you more about whether the bit is fitted properly or not than any kind of static rule that someone might give you regarding how many wrinkles should be at the corner of the horse's mouth. Now, when you put your finger in and you check the horse's tongue, make sure it can't get its tongue behind it. Also double check, especially with geldings, that there aren't any wolf teeth that are interfering with the action of the mouthpiece. You want to make sure that on our bit, at least, that there's plenty of room on any bit, that there's plenty of room so that there's no pinching here at the cheeks. Now, this is a really big mare. She stands about 16'2", and you can see that our bit actually extends a little bit beyond her lips. That's by design. That eliminates pinching and makes for nice, smooth swivel action, nice, easy response to the bit when you pull.